thanks for tuning in to a special web-only edition of Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN. I'm Dan. He's Drew. We have a discussion. Which is better, the regular season of college basketball or the regular season of college football? And a lot of people have been talking about this because now in college football, we're getting every week updates on the rankings. They have the College Football Playoff Committee meeting, including Barry Alvarez, each week, and they come up with a top 25. And a lot of people are saying they should do that for college basketball, putting the top seeds in there, and it would create more interest. So which one is better?
I think right now I'm going to go college football for the reasons that you state, and just because every game and every week we haven't seen a dominant team. We've seen a lot of ebbs and flows, and that's giving us storylines. In college basketball, Duke, North Carolina is great and all, but does it really matter? The top teams are going to get in. They're going to get high seeds. There isn't that much drama anymore to the regular season. There aren't that many, like, with players coming and going like they do, there aren't that many marquee player matchups. There's just not that much to grab onto until you get to March Madness now. The regular season college basketball, to me, has been devalued. Winning the conference doesn't really mean anything until you get to the conference tournament, so it's just everything's devalued. It's becoming like the NBA season.
Well, it's an odd time for us to ask this because interest in Wisconsin basketball may be at the highest point ever right now, with Bo Ryan's team coming off the Final Four, being ranked number 3 in the preseason poll, Frank Kaminsky named the number 1 player in college basketball by ESPN.
Yeah.
And that in itself, and this is not in any way to degrade Frank Kaminsky, okay? But college basketball right now, I feel, not there on the level of college football because too many of the best players leave after 1 year or 2 years in a rare case. Frank Kaminsky in the olden days with his talent level would probably be second team preseason All-American because there would be guys that have played for a couple of years that, you know, I think back to like a Grant Hill who stayed 4 years at Duke, a very talented player at a top program. And he was a preseason All-American probably his last 2 years. You don't have guys like that anymore. Usually the very best players in college basketball jump to the NBA right away. So every once in a while, a Frank Kaminsky comes along who plays very little as a freshman and sophomore, just explodes in his development, and overnight is the best player in college basketball. He didn't go pro, whereas most guys do.
He's a terrific story, and it's fun to watch, and his development's been fun, and that's a fun team to watch. The Badgers, I mean, a lot of people will rip them and say, well, they're boring. They know who cares about that style.
Not boring
anymore.
We
know the personalities, and we see them every week, and we appreciate winning in these parts, and they've done that. But if they lose to Michigan State, it's not going to be the end of the world. We've seen that the college ranks are reflecting the pros in that college football has become a week-to-week thing. Teams are getting slaughtered 1 week and then playing well the next. And in basketball, we're just waiting for the tournament. So we're waiting for the playoffs.
Right.
And I don't know what they can do to get that back because how do you build that? Remember how big the Big East was, those big Monday games and stuff? Is there that sizzle like every game's on TV now? There's nothing that's really special to me about college basketball's regular season. It's just there are some good games and they're entertaining and it gives you something to watch on a cold winter night. But there's nothing really that I can glom onto.
Right. And the very best college football players go pro early too. Basketball isn't the only one, but usually they wait till after their junior year, maybe a sophomore year, but it's usually junior year. And so the level of talent in college football right now, I feel, is higher than the level of talent in college basketball because you just keep losing so many players, it's going to level off at some point. College basketball also, with so many teams making it into the NCAA tournament, we're used to it. There's a generation that has no idea that once upon a time there were 32 teams in the NCAA tournament. Back then, and I don't mean to be old guy out on the front lawn, but I think back to 1974, the year Marquette lost to North Carolina State in the national championship game. North Carolina State almost didn't even make it into the NCAA tournament because the conferences sent one team to the tournament, and they had to beat Maryland in an epic overtime game. Maryland may have been the second best team in college basketball, and they had to go to the NIT.
Well, nowadays, didn't the Warriors squeak in 77
yes.
too as an independent?
And nowadays, the top 10 teams from the ACC probably will make the NCAA tournament. And so it's a little bit watered down in that way. College basketball then is what NCAA football is now, where for the college football playoff, unless it's the SEC, and we don't know yet what's going to happen there, but if you're not a conference champion, you can't even think of going to the college football playoff. Right now, we don't think a Big Ten team will get there because of They'll look back at the beginning of the year, Wisconsin losing to LSU, Ohio State losing to Virginia Tech, Michigan State losing to Oregon. Those still resonate because they didn't play any other games outside the conference anymore. And is the Big Ten good enough to put a team in the playoff? We don't know. But it does take me back a little bit to those days when the NCAA tournament was for the very elite. And this college football playoff is for the very elite.
In college football. So the very elite is the SEC. Are you getting the feeling that that's starting to erode a little bit? Their dominance of the whole landscape is starting to
wane? Well, they're also even right now. That's part of their problem. You know, Auburn will beat LSU 1 week and then lose the next week. And
that's
it just keeps going around in a circle.
Yeah.
But then you get an overall record for each team and you have only four teams getting into the playoff, that's going to hurt the SEC.
You're right, and I've been a snob that way because I always thought that a two-loss Alabama team could be better than most conference champions in other leagues. It's just a fact. You said it the way it is. But it just seems to me right now college football has, like, the mojo. Their regular season, the games are more impactful. And I'm looking forward to watching basketball when Marquette's underway and the Badgers, but it just doesn't grab me right now because in the big picture of these games, you know, it's nice to win your conference, but it's not that big a deal.
We agree. That's it.
That's a big deal.
We quit. We're done. We're never going to do this again. We actually agreed. But we will have more shows. Please join us every Saturday at 6:30. Big 12 Sports Saturday with 540 ESPN. And you can listen to us on the radio as well on 540 ESPN. Thanks for joining us.